स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम् वन्देहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलम् श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपदान् सगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्ण करुणा सिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधाकांत नमोस्तुते तप्तकांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
Hare Krishna. We all will recite Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya 3 times together. व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीं उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी हरे कृष्ण All of you may have seen Hollywood or Bollywood movies. Is that right? Everybody interested in movies here? Yes or no?
Yes.
Depends on what kind of movies.
Noah, you interested in the movies?
Oh yeah.
How many movies you see every week? At least one.
Yeah.
Correct. Everybody of us, right? So the theme of most of the Bollywood or Hollywood movies is, what is the theme? Most of the time, not always.
Love.
goes around love story, right? Love story. And what happens in the love story? There is a hero, there is a heroine, and there is a villain, right? And there are obstacles, and they overcome and they meet. And that's how they make millions of dollars. Isn't it? However, where does the origin of the love story comes, you know? Who is the original love story person, or who is the original hero? So, in the Vedas and in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there are beautiful love stories on which beautiful movies have been made. I'm going to talk about one of such wonderful love stories. And we learn from it. What do we learn? How to please the person whom you love. That's called as Valentine Day. You know, you please somebody whom you love on that particular day. So, here is a personality, Krishna, and there is a girl next to Krishna, and her name is?
Rukmini.
Rukmini. Have you heard this name before? No? How about you? Have you heard this before name? Rukmini? Okay, so Krishna is standing in front of us with whom?
Radha.
Radha. However, Krishna is not married to, in the eyes of the material world, he is not married to Radha. But Krishna got married to, how many wives Krishna had? 16,108 wives Krishna had.
Oh my God.
Is that a surprise for you? Is that a surprise for you, Noah?
Right?
Is that a news to you? 16,108. We have a difficulty with one.
No surprise to me, actually.
Krishna had 16,000, and here is the wife, and her name is, as she rightly said, Rukmini. So there is a beautiful story of Krishna and Rukmini's marriage in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto is right here. And in this 10th canto, there is a beautiful story of, it's a love story, of Krishna and Rukmini. And we're going to talk about this story today. So in Maharashtra, in India, there are various states. One of the states is Maharashtra. State is the province. And in Maharashtra, there is a place called as Vidarbha. Have you heard Vidarbha, Prabhuji? Right?
Nagpur.
Yes, correct. So, in Vidarbha, there was a king. And his name was?
Rukmi.
Bhishmak. Okay. Bhishmak had 5 sons and 1 daughter. And the eldest of his son was Rukmi, as she rightly said. And the other 4 sons were also named by the word Ruk, which is Rukmartha, Rukma Bahu, Rukma Kesha, Rukma Mali. These are the 4 names of other 4 names. The first one is Rukmi. And the daughter, her name was Rukmini. So those, that is the word Rukmini. Rukmini is the name of the daughter of Bhishmak, King Bhishmak. Now Rukmini was very, very beautiful. And she had all the wonderful qualities. You know, guna. Very nice guna, very nice quality. She was learned. She was intelligent. You know, when they judge Miss Universe or Miss World, they just don't look at the beauty. They look at overall, you know, they ask them the questions and how they answer and like that. And Rukmini was one of the Miss Universe at that time. Actually, Rukmini is the incarnation of Lakshmi, Goddess Lakshmi, appearing as a Rukmini. So she was as beautiful as Mother Lakshmi. And Rukmini was very young when she heard about Lord Krishna and his activities and how he looked. So Krishna lived in Dwarka. So Dwarka is in Gujarat. Gujarat is in another province. And Rukmini was in
Maharashtra.
So these are two different provinces, and the distance is quite a bit. If you want to go from Gujarat to Maharashtra, it takes almost how many hours?
20. It depends. Means from Pune to.
If you drive, it takes about 15 hours. 15 hours.
Pune to Ahmedabad, it's about 18 hours.
18 hours. So it takes about 18 to 20 hours, depending upon the way you travel. Now at that time, there were no buses or trains, so it used to take a little longer actually. Right. So Rukmini heard about Lord Krishna and his activities in Dwarka and his all the wonderful leelas which he performed in his childhood while she was in Vidarbha. And hearing about the activities of Krishna, Rukmini was very much attracted. You know, some of us may not have seen some wonderful person like, say, Prime Minister of India or Prime Minister of Canada or President of America. They are very famous people, but we don't get the chance to see them. But what do we, how do we learn about them? By hearing about them through the newspaper, through the people, like that. Is that right? Is everybody with me?
Yes, and apps too, like yeah. CNN app.
CNN, yes. So through the news, through the internet. So Rukmini heard about Krishna from the people who came to visit his father. What was the name of his father?
Bhishmak.
And Rukmini was very, very much attracted to Krishna, and she wanted to marry Krishna. So she had decided that she, if she will ever get married, she will marry to Krishna himself. Without looking at the girl or boy, you decide to get married with that person. How is that possible? It's not possible nowadays.
Impossible.
But
in the olden days, it was
like that. But Krishna's activities were so famous and his description was so famous that Rukmini was much attracted to him, and even without seeing at Krishna, she decided to get married to Krishna. So Rukmini wanted to marry him, but his brother, eldest brother, what was the name of the eldest brother?
Rukmi.
Rukmi had decided that she will not marry Krishna because Rukmi was envious to Krishna. So Rukmi decided that Rukmini will marry whom?
Shishupal.
So Duryodhan was not of Rukmini, decided that she will marry Shishupal. Now Shishupal was also an envious person, and he was a cruel person, like, you know, villain. Every movies have a villain, right? All the love stories have a villain. So here the villains are entering one by one. So first villain was Rukmi, the second villain was Shishupal, and both of them have decided that Rukmini will not marry Krishna. So when Rukmini came to know that Rukmi does not want him to marry Krishna, then she was very worried and she was anxious. So what did she do? Nowadays, when a girl is in love with a boy, what does she do? She sends him a text message, or a boy is in the love with a girl, what does he do? He will send a flower or something like that, right? But at that time, there was no SMS, no phone call, no email. So how did that go?
Letter.
You know, writing a letter.
Sort of like that.
So Rukmini wanted to marry Krishna, and she sent a love letter. You know, first love letter, if somebody sent to someone, that was Rukmini sent to Krishna. And it is a girl sending it to boy, not boy sending it to girl. Okay, it's a reverse, other way around. Right? So this is the first love. Now people say love at first sight, but this is not even at the sight. Rukmini had never seen Krishna. She had just heard about Krishna, and the hearing was so much attractive for her that she said, no, I will marry him. And at that time, 5,000 years back, you see, nowadays also even a girl sends a letter to a boy, people look at it, something fishy going on. It becomes a news nowadays, right? At that time, it was a big step, 5,000 years back. So Rukmini wrote a letter to Krishna. And what did she write in the letter? So I'm going to read a letter. Will you like to read a love letter? How many of you would like? How are you, Rohini? Would you like to read a love letter?
Sure.
Sure, let's read, you know. What should she write? Because this is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. A love letter is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. So Srimad Bhagavatam is a book which is beyond any religion. It's a book about how to live the life by loving others, you know, by the examples. And there are so many wonderful devotees whose lives have been described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and one of them is Rukmini here. So Rukmini writes a letter, a love letter to Krishna in which language? Not in English, okay. But we have translated that in English for you, but this is in Sanskrit. But for the benefit of all of us, we are going to read a love letter. Will that help us to increase our love for Krishna? So Rukmini writes to Krishna. First of all, she doesn't write that, dear Krishna, to my darling, my honey. Okay, she just writes, dear Krishna, ever since I have heard about you, my Lord, I have become completely attracted to you. Just by? How?
Hearing.
So Rukmini was attracted to Krishna through the ears, not through the eyes. Then she writes, O Krishna, I have fixed my mind upon you. And what is that mind? She describes that? Shameless mind. Why does she say that? Because it was not the desire of her brother or the family members for her to get married to Krishna. They wanted her to marry Shishupal. So she says, O Krishna, I have fixed my shameless mind upon you. O Krishna, without fail, please come before my marriage to Shishupal and kidnap me. What is she saying? A boy and a girl. Now here, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You know? And Rukmini is saying that please come and protect me. From whom?
Shishupal.
From Shishupal, from the envious person. The people who are envious, we should not keep that company. And this is what Rukmini is saying, that Shishupal is envious of you, my brother Rukmini is envious of you, please protect me from them and please take me away. In accordance with the family customs, on the day before my marriage, I will visit a temple of Durga, goddess Ambika. You know, in Maharashtra, there is a Durga temple many places. Even in Gujarat also, many places there are Durga temples. And it is the custom at that particular time for the bride to visit Durga temple. Durga is nothing but the Parvati, actually. And why do they visit? Why do girls visit Shiva or Parvati? For a good husband, actually. Not to take a blessing upon that my married life be successful And please give us a blessing that as Goddess Durga was or Parvati was fortunate to get Shiva as the husband, we will become fortunate enough. So, she said, I will visit the temple of Goddess Ambika and that will be the best opportunity to you to appear and easily, what is the word?
Kidnap.
Kidnap me. Have anybody kidnapped a girl here? For the marriage, not for ransom money. The first kidnapper on the planet is Krishna, who kidnapped Rukmini.